Hi guys, here is Dante, and in today's video I wanted to do a fast showcase of Marimo and her weapon. I was lucky enough to summon two of her weapon, and I was able to summon her as well. So here she is, her weapon. I've already polished it, and the stats are the same as Remiel. She has slightly more HP, but that's all. And right at the moment, I have equipped her with my best CDR runes. And why is this? Because her ultimate grants a stun for 1 second and reduces cooldown recovery speed by 70%. And this means that the fastest you can stun your enemies, the lower will be their recharging rate. So if you just equip her with poor CDR reduction runes, she will cast her ultimate after maybe 2 or 3 seconds, and at that point Ive, because we all know that we are talking about Ive, she will be a direct counter of her in the PvP arena. Ive will just be near to cast her ultimate, so the 70% reduction will be meaningless. Instead, if you are fast enough to cast your ultimate just right at the start of the PvP match, then she will be a lot slower. She will lose 1 second and maybe another one thanks to the 70% reduction. And then I wanted to highlight this thing. It deals 700% attack damage and skill damage increase by 30% depending on the wizard synergy level. So what this means? This means that if you have a weapon that maybe is a plus 5, she will one shot Ive, and every Ive will have to wear the shield artifact, obviously the wind one. But every Ive will have to wear a shield artifact, because she will have enough attack, even with CDR runes, to kill every Ive on the battlefield. This requires a lot of gems, a big investment, and tomorrow I will release another video with all the things that I gained from my experience with her in PvE. I cleared all the early stages of chapter 10 in hard mode. I cleared all of these stages with her, all but the boss stage. Here I really needed two snipers, Raven and Ive, to be able to kill him within the 20 seconds window. But apart from that, I cleared all these stages with Marimo information. So, for example, I cannot make you see this one, but let's see. This was my formation when I cleared 10-9, and she was the MVP of that stage. She's not bad in PvE as well, and I will make you see why. I will just make one match start. At the moment, I do not have my runes on the Remiel and Nerst, so I can't fight properly. But I will make you see what she is capable of. And 1 second CDR right at the start. And she stuns all this row. This means that if she starts in the second row, she will stun every enemy in the second row. If she starts in the front line, she will stun all the enemy front line. In the back row, all the enemy back row. This is what her ability does. And it's not bad. Here we are. They are casting their ultimate now, so it is not really a bad ultimate. She can really help a lot with the sustainability of your team. All the damage you can see here, she dealt it, so it's not bad. If my Remiel and my Nerst had their runes, she for sure would have been able to clear that stage. So let's go to the PvP arena. And let's try some matches here. This is the formation I am using right now. I find it the most efficient and the best right now at the moment. My second squad is just full of snipers because they are the best at the moment to not deploy the warrior comp. I could just put the unknown knight, Hilda, and so on, and use the warrior comp, but I wanted to use a composition of knights that everybody could use, even without a lot of investment in all the warriors. So right now I'm gonna switch teams, and as you can see, we have one blinded here and one blinded here. Chances are that Ive will be one of these, and I will make you see how Marimo effectively negates the enemy Ive. So let's start. Here, this is a pretty common formation, the magic, the wizard formation. But with the summons, I even pulled two of Tristan's bows. So right now I have his weapon at +5 and he deals a lot of damage. And as you can see here, there is the Ive enemy. Got stunned and erased, guys. Erased. She just dealt a lot of damage. You will make, you will be able to pause the video and see how much damage she dealt. But for real, she with maybe a +5 weapon will be able alone to kill a whole row of snipers. Let's do another match. Let's look for maybe another Ive. Here she is. So this is what I was looking for. I want to test my second formation against assassins. And one thing is for sure, this formation is really great for attack, but you cannot be really good at the defense with it, because you cannot place Marimo where you want, and the enemy will just adjust his formation and maybe place Ive in the second, in the center, or in the back. But there is a way you can avoid this from happen. In set defense, you will just blind your Aqua and your Marimo. So maybe you can place them this way, and the enemy will not be able to know until the fight starts where she is, if she is in the center or in the back row. So it is a 50% chance that you will be able to evade her stun if you find these days maybe a Bernard in the enemy composition and an Ive. You will know that Marimo is in the formation as well. So you have a 50% chance to just be able to kill Marimo and Ive, always if your Ive is faster. Otherwise, this formation is really, really, really weak against assassins. If you want, I can lose a match here. Maybe I will lose this one on purpose. I will make you see. So at the moment, let's fight this one. The first match, the assassins will be shut down. And I am just relying here on Tristan's ultimate because Ember will die for sure. And we are good. Maybe, and I say maybe, if the enemy assassins were wearing all CD or critical runes, they would be able to win. So let's see. Now she cast her ultimate and they are dead. The enemy had the loss shield on them, so she couldn't really deal a lot of damage, but as you saw, she can negate the enemy Ive. And let's continue, and I will lose on purpose this first match. I will change, I will use this formation, so Marimo will anyway stun all of these enemies. So we will see if we are able to survive. Maybe we will place Kevin on the center, so if the enemy uses their ultimate, maybe Ive will be able to survive. Let's start, and she just locks all of them, and here it comes, Ive's ultimate, and we are dead. Yeah, because Marimo died. If she could survive, we would have been able maybe to win even the other match, but right now we are doomed. Ive will cast her ultimate and kill everybody. Yes. That's the way of the arena right now. Let's just keep going. Let's see in the revenge if I have someone. Okay, I can do this one. So if you find a warrior comp on the enemy team, the only thing you have to do is place all your attack units in the back row and use this formation. If you want, yes, I'm sure that I will win this. So if you want, you can play like this. You can place Loss in the front row, so all the enemy team will be shut down, and I will make you see. Here, all of them are shut down. Even if they have just 1 second cooldown on their ultimate, they won't be able to just kill all of you, because they won't be able to cast their ultimate. And I will win this match for sure. So Marimo right now is a granted ticket to win against Ive. Obviously, if she is not really... Oh, maybe I'm going to lose, incredible. I'm going to lose. I was not expecting this. It seems that my Ive damage was not enough to kill them. And this is it. I'm done. I lost this stage. Not expecting this at all. They had a lot of combat power, if I'm not wrong. Yes, I should have expected it. When you have one formation that have your total combat power, it means that they have a lot of attack and a lot of HP. So here you see 180, 180, 160. So my Ive at the moment is just level 100. And she is not able to kill with just one sweep all enemy teams with that much higher level. And that is why I lost. I was careless, but it doesn't matter. I just wanted to make you see a few examples of Marimo gameplays, so it was good. So I will switch positions here, and let's see if we can win this one as well. And this one, 160, 140... maybe again I will not be able to win this, but you know what, here you can see that this Ive is really, she must have maybe a plus 5 weapon, because this player bought her skin, so chances are that she will be really at a high attack percentage and high attack speed runes. Let's see, this will be my last battle and a really good example for you guys. So they are all shut down, I am relying on Tristan's ultimate here. This, okay, we should be good, we should be good, okay, we are good. And here comes her ultimate and they are all stunned, and yes! Anyway, with the first ultimate we just killed them all. And as you can see, even if you find a really overpowered Ive, always if she is not level maybe 160, you will be able to block her. And this is your granted ticket to a victory in the PvP arena. For sure, if you have even a second comp that is really strong. So this is it for this video, guys. I really wanted to give you an example of Marimo's ability. Tomorrow, if... I will be able to make it in time, I will release a complete guide where I will make you see her potential in PvE as well. And see you tomorrow, bye!